Next principle we are going to consider here is communication. So within the different rooms of the home, easy communication should be possible. Okay, this can be done with the proper placement of doors and the windows. So if there are number of doors and number of windows that are in the home, and if there is not sufficient passage within the home, so it will be a hindrance or it will be an obstruction for the easy communication. So then what happens is, a person in one particular room should travel some distance within the home itself to communicate something to the other person who is sitting in the other part of the home. So with the proper placement of the doors and the windows, okay, and with having sufficient passage within the home, a central passage, if it is possible, it should be given, so that it will be helpful for easy communication. So if a person is sitting in one particular room, he can communicate or he can just talk something which is clearly heard by the other person who is sitting in the other room. So that is what the communication principle means. Then coming to the economy. So if we are hiring locally available materials, so it will help us in reducing the cost of the construction. So if we don't go for rich finishes, that is external finishes or internal finishes, the interiors, so nowadays people are spending much on the interiors. So if you don't want to spend much on the interiors, we just want a simple home, so that will cut down the cost of the home. So by this technique or by these principles, we can cut down the cost so that we can have a good economical construction. Then coming to the elegance part. So elegance means how actually our home looks in the elevation part. Elevation part means the height part. If you stand in front of your home, you just see how beautiful your home looks in the height wise or in the elevation wise. If you are having good designs on the doors and windows, if you have just left creepers from the terrace, that is floating or hanging from the terrace, so that it looks good. If you are having good painting on the home or on the walls of the home, if you have chosen good color of the paint, that it goes or it gives good look. So this is what all covered under the elegance, that is how beautiful your home looks when you see in the elevation part or height wise. Then coming to the furniture requirement. So it is obvious that each room of the home has different furniture requirement. So now if the hall requires sofa and some chairs to be put up there, so that people who are coming from outside can have a discussion with us, they can sit comfortably on the sofa. The same furniture cannot be given in the kitchen, right? So in the kitchen we have dining table. So that dining table usually we do not keep in the hall. So the furniture requirement changes from one room to another. So if I am having a cot in the bedroom, or if I have placed some cupboard or shelf in my bedroom, so the same thing cannot be done in a classroom of a particular school or a college. So that is, each room requires different furnitures. That is what it means. So another thing we can consider is practical consideration. So how practical our construction can be? That is, we can take an example of cleanliness. See, if you are having much articles or objects that are decorative pieces in our home, so it becomes difficult to clean those decorative pieces or materials when compared to the other materials. So because it is very sensitive, we are having a danger that when we are cleaning, the material can fall off and it can break. So practically we have to think what materials we require in the home and what materials we do not require. And also when we consider the economical consideration, I have already discussed about the economy. So that is also one of the part of the practically considering the things when we are going to construct the house or home. So these are the different 12 principles of the building planning. Thank you.